It is said that laws are made for man and not man for the law. The reasons why laws are made is to solve problems. When you are in a dire situation, like I used to say, you will need a dire solution to get out of the situation. This bill that I want to talk about is a very radical one, but it's very needed. It's a bill to see that civil servants retire after 15 years and no longer 35 years. Because the present law we have is for civil servants to work for 35 years. But that law, as it seems right now, is outdated. It's no longer relevant in our today's Nigeria. We have 50% of our population is said to be below 35 years of age. According to the Bureau of Statistics, our unemployment rate is about 33%. You know what that means? It means if we are 185 million people, 60 million or so do not have jobs. 60 million of not just ordinary people, of youth do not have jobs. And you know the youth are the productive, the youth stage is the productive stage, is the stage where you have strength, is the stage where you have dynamism, is the stage where you have productivity. 60 million of that population do not have job. I'm not talking about the underemployed, those ones that are working, that are being paid 15,000 naira, 18,000 naira every month. In our today's Nigeria, 18,000 naira cannot do anything. There are millions of people that are working just because they are working, just to see two square meals to eat, not to even pay house rent. So we're talking about 33% unemployment rate, youth unemployment rate in Nigeria, which means we have 60 million of our productive youth not working. And the result is what we are seeing in our society today. And every 3 months, we see our universities dishing out graduates to go for NYSC, dishing out graduates, and there is no concrete plans for this youth. There's no concrete put in place to create employment for them. There is absolute need to pursue policies and laws that will cater for the situation we are in, and that is why I want to pursue this bill to ensure that the retirement age is actually reduced from 35 years to 15 years. After working for 15 years, you already have 15 years is a lot of experience. The law, when they made that law, we were about, is it 30 million or 40 million people then? But now we have 180 or going to 200 million. So that law is outdated. I don't see the reason why we keep laws that do not favor us in the present situation. So this law, we allow for people that have worked for 15 years to retire. They are paid very well, they are well paid their gratuity, they are well paid their pension, and they are taken care of. They want to go into business, they can easily go into business and employ people. Not that a young man that is just graduating from school with no experience or whatsoever, with no contacts, you give the person 2 million or 3 million or 250,000 naira, say go and start a business. There is a statistic that says that startups in this country, about over 50% or even 80% of them do not survive after 6 months or so. So how do you expect somebody with no experience just lecture on entrepreneurship to go start business and become successful and employ people? But a man that has 15 years of experience in civil service will be able to manage the business, be able to handle contracts, will have contacts to actually continue his business. So it makes more sense to retire people after 15 years of service, then give them money, train them on entrepreneurship, let them go for fresh blood to come in to innovate the civil service. If you look at our civil service, the place looks like a graveyard. No innovation. When you enter a government institution, you will know that it's a government institution. You see broken chairs, you see the people sleeping, you see people doing the people are old, the people are fat, they are not motivated. When you have young people that want to explore, young people that are energized, that have vision, you see the civil service sector transform. You won't have to be seeing people doing contracts. The civil servants are supposed to be the ones that will be doing in the Ministry of Work. It is the civil servant that is supposed to be working. But what do we have? We have civil service. When I was serving, they used to when they deploy you to some ministries, they call the Ministry of No Work because they don't do nothing. And the reason is because there is no innovation in the civil service. The civil service is not productive at all. So if we have young people there are many things that we're going to benefit. One, we're going to create employment space for the young people. Number two, the money you use to pay somebody that is in level, I don't even know what this level they call them, that is in management level, whatever, that is earning about 200,000 naira every month. If you want to employ a new graduate, you would have, instead of paying that 200,000 naira for one person, you would have broken it down to like, is it 50,000 that is the entry point? I don't know. But you would have broken it down into about two or three persons. You have saved, you have given money, you have transferred money from, instead of one person who has already been established for years of service, to giving to somebody that is just starting school and is earning decent income. So it makes more sense. And another advantage is that the civil service will be productive. One, you are creating employment for the young people to reduce the 33% unemployment rate. Number two, you are saving money. You are directly giving money to, instead of one person, you are giving money to about 3 to 4 persons. Number four, the civil service will now be innovative, because you have young people, young minds that are intelligent, that are ready to work, that are innovative, that want to bring in ICT, that want to bring in ideas to make the sector or the agency or the department grow and become not as it used to be. Then number four, you will have the retired people, those that have retired after 15 years, go into entrepreneurship and be able to employ other people. It makes more sense if a man that have a 15 years experience working to go into entrepreneurship and he will succeed. There's more likelihood for him to succeed than somebody that just graduated from school. So, this bill, however we are going to pursue it, if as a federating unit, as a state, we can't make it happen, we will look for other means. If it's to liaise with our senior colleagues in the National Assembly, we will liaise. Laws, like I said, laws are made for man, not man for law. The reasons why laws are made is to solve problems. And we are in a dire situation. If we don't do something to our youths, over 60 million are unemployed. The ones that can stomach the urge to go into fraud, go into fraud. The ones that cannot stomach going into fraud, that are not intelligent to go into fraud, that can steal, going to armed robbery and killing. The ones that cannot go into killing, cannot do fraud, 419, goes into Yahoo. That is ritual. Now make using ritual, using their boys to do ritual, using their parents to do ritual, using their wives to do ritual. Is that the kind of society we want to build? Is that the kind of future we want to build? We will continue to face constant insecurity if we do not do this. This is one of the ways we can reduce unemployment, to shift the focus from old people to young people, because the young people are the future of tomorrow, and the young people are much more than the old people in our country. As we do this, we believe that God willing, God helping us, will succeed.